And to Shikari, welcome to Kerrang Radio.
Hello.
Thank you.
Well, two of you anyway.
Yes.
Where are the other guys?
Skiving.
Skivers,
skiving,
yeah.
Off school.
Oh, well.
No, I think they're doing... Rory's doing some...
We've got a lot of prep going on for the next tours and stuff happening, so a few changes that need work on. Otherwise, nothing will work.
The boring side of rock and roll. Mm, the programming, the lead coiling. The
That sounds quite fun.
It can be.
After a few days of it, it starts to get a bit...
Mm. Okay. And is Rory in charge of that? Is he the good person to put in charge of that?
No,
stuff?
He's just the last one to actually get it sorted and do it. We're all done, the rest of us.
Okay. So you're getting ready for the new tour for the new album, which I've had a listen to. Amazing. Brilliant, as always.
Thank you.
Really good. And you don't shy away from talking about the issues, as per usual.
No.
how are you actually feeling? I'm going to go a little bit political now. How are you actually feeling about the current situation, like the Farage and Russell Brand and all that kind of stuff going on?
We tend to sort of actually stay out of party politics. I mean, obviously it's hard to when you've got people like Farage, and it's just, it becomes almost like a, taking the mick out of itself, it just becomes unreal. It's like beyond parody almost. I think Russell Brand's doing a good job. I don't agree with all his spiritual babble, but like, I think just the fact that someone of such a stature is actually speaking about real stuff,
yeah, exactly,
good, and he's entertaining, so, but you know, it brings people into it that probably would never even be.
Yeah, there's no one else of his stature that, you know, people are going to listen to him. People, a slightly younger generation, that no one else is doing that, so that can only ever be respected.
It seems like he's getting a bit of a hard time from the media for it, for being a rich person talking about this stuff, but he's actually kind of talking a lot of sense at times. Not a lot of sense sometimes as well.
Yeah. He likes to use big words and speak about God and things like that, which... Not really into.
Well, what you do talk about in the new album, one of the things is the NHS, and that's the song we've just put the video out for as well, which is great. It starts off kind of quite dark, and then it just goes into a real mind-bending place. But is that something that you've been looking at a lot recently?
Yeah, well, when we were off tour, we did a few marches with, like, Save the NHS and thing, and sort of NGOs. Did a bit of work in that, and that was just quite eye-opening, really, just to see that how much is going on behind the doors, like this slow move into privatization, which I think free healthcare is just so important, taking care of the vulnerable in society is so important, and it was just something that we wanted to write about, to attack those that put profit over people, I suppose.
Fair enough. And with there being a video, is that going to be the next single?
Yeah.
Cool. Oh, I'm looking forward to playing that a lot on the air. Excellent. We've had The Last Garrison going around a lot. Great reaction on that so far.
Excellent.
Is it, I guess, playing it out live? You've been playing a lot of the tunes out live?
Yeah. There's about four we're playing live now. Mm. Basically, the ones that people have heard are the ones we started playing live. But Last Garrison, I don't think we realised how much fun it was going to be playing that live.
Yeah.
It was a certain... First time we played it, it was like, damn, this is fun.
Yeah. When that chorus
we were just kind of bopping
in
around stage, like... Really good fun.
It must take a lot of work for you guys to sort of work out how to take what you've produced in the studio and then make it live, because it, you know, you've got so many different layers and it goes all over the place.
Mm.
How do you simplify that down?
Well, it takes a while. I mean, in the studio, I think we used to think about, you know, how are we going to do this live kind of thing, but now we try not to, because, you know, really only ever puts limitations on you in the studio. So now we just be creative in the studio and we go, we'll figure it out later, which is what we've been doing the last few months.
Now we hate ourselves.
Now, yeah. It has been a long road.
Yeah. There's one line in the song that keeps, well, in the album, sorry, that keeps on cropping up everywhere I look online, and it's the "you effing spanner." People are saying,
poetry.
I'm loving the fact that that is in a song right now.
Yeah, it's a pleasure to scream at people.
We aim to please.
it's an honour.
I also really enjoyed "Dear Future Historians," which is a ballad, like 6.5 minute long ballads, which I thought was great. You've done ballads before, but to stick it as the second to last track on the album as well, was it kind of you just calming everyone down just before the final onslaught in the last tune?
Just being cheeky, really.
Breath. Yeah, yeah. A moment of reflection.
Yeah.
Just before we kick you out the door. The last track.
Nice. The tour, well, that's starting very soon. You're off to Europe and then you come to the UK. So it's actually, yeah, in a couple of days, you're going to be in Europe. And are you fully ready? Was it just roaring?
I don't know. We'll find out.
I think we're going to kind of have to keep changing bits and bobs over the tour, because we're kind of going through a period where we're doing a lot of changing. So there's no exact switch. It's going to have to be half old, half new, and kind of keep slogging away as we're touring. But it will get there. But we're almost ready.
Okay. You'll be ready by the time you hit the UK anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
Nice. And Download as well in summer.
Mm.
That's going to be a big show.
Can't wait.
Go on.
Yeah, no, I mean, we did that stage sort of the same slot before 2 years ago.
Was that 2 years ago?
Something like, yeah, maybe three. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, it was.
But yeah, and now we had to play, like, there was like a watershed where all the stages had to finish before Iron Maiden went on.
Mm.
And there's not that this year, so we can play in the darkness, and it'll be like all our lighting will have a much bigger effect in the production, so we're going to go balls out in that respect as well.
You're up against Kiss, aren't you?
Yeah.
Mm. Now, in my personal opinion, Kiss, great, legends, but I know where I'm going to be. Definitely watching you guys. I think you might put a bit more energy into the show.
We'd hope so. I mean, we've still got a few years on them, haven't we?
Yeah. Nice. Well, guys, thank you so much for joining me today, and best of luck with the album, The Mindsweep.
Thank you.
Thank you.